Hello everyone. So let's continue from our previous video. And in this video, we were talking about DOM. So we will extend the discussion on DOM in this video. So document object model, this talks about accessing a particular DOM node using document.get element by ID, tag name or class name. This document.get element by ID will give us a single ID, but consider that you have another use case where you are getting, you are using this another method. Get element by class name. So what it will do, it will give you the element array. You will not be able to just find this particular method here dot on click. Okay, so what you will do is this element, we'll just access the zeroth element. If you just try to just put, so here document.get element by class name or document.get element by tag name. So we'll just put element one. So here you can see we have a length property. So what we can do is we can just check the length property. If the length is greater than 0, means what do we have? We can access the element, and here we will access 0th property and dot on click. All these methods or all these properties we can access here, like dot inner HTML you can access, or you can change the style. So these are the other methods we have: document.get element by class name, tag name, or document.get element by ID. ID will return a single node and it is returning an array. So you have to check, okay, do we got the length greater than 0? Then only just apply all these things like inner HTML, just change the style, you change the DOM behavior like this. So other than that, you can also attach a DOM event like element.onClick. There are many ways of doing it. Element.addEventListener. This is another way. Like now you can see all the events. Okay, I will try to show you again. Yeah, you can see it is add event listener is having all these event name, abort, activate, change, click, all these methods which you can see doing mouse over. So here I'm doing a click event and this is the callback function. So this function will get executed whenever you click onto this particular element. Similarly, we have element 10. This is also the some node object. So here also you can do add event listener and you can just provide okay, on key down, on key up, or you just need to provide the event name properly so that whenever it happens you should be able to get the function executed. Or another way of doing it is element one dot on click and define a function. So the only difference is here you are adding an event listener, right? So this event listener will always be there. You have registered it for this particular DOM node. So wherever you click on it, this will get triggered and you will get the value out of it. Okay, apart from this, what we can talk about is the different ways to create element, append element and change the elements. So create element, if you wanted to create a new element, like unordered list, ULLI. You wanted to create new li and you wanted to append it in ul, so you can just use document.createElementLi, and once this li element is created, you can just append it. This element you can just pass the append into. So here you can, there it can be a parent element, parent element dot append child element, so it's a li, and parent element can be a ul, so you can do append. Okay, there are multiple ways to access the DOM using get element by ID, get element by tag name, get element by class name, get element by some CSS selectors. So CSS selectors, we have a query selector and query selector all. So that we can use in our method. So basic thing, we already know that document.get element by ID and document.get element by class name, tag name. Apart from that, we can also use this query selector. Another important thing, I will just remove all the code from here. Okay, what it is doing is it will try to give us all the elements, all the nodes having class name example. Okay, so query selector all will always returns an array. There is another method, query selector, that is same as document.get element by ID. It will only give a single node object. Query selector all will give us all the objects. See, these are called CSS selectors, so you can specify a particular selector. Okay, in the paragraph tag I have this class example. In the paragraph tag somewhere, if you see the example, then just fetch it. So query selector, these are called CSS selectors. You can specify one or more CSS selectors to match the element. These are used to select an HTML node based on the ID, class name, type, attribute, and all. So here you can just look at the CSS selector reference, like what all CSS selectors you can pass. Okay, you can pass a single class, like class1.class2. Okay, you can just simple provide a simple class, so it will select all the nodes having class1 and class2. You just provide an ID, so it is covering everything. It's a single method, can do everything. You don't need to worry about document.getElementById or class name or tag name. Okay, it will just select all the elements having ID equal to, you can just put F name for removing the confusion. So where you see something like this, it will select all those elements. You can specify the single class, multiple classes, ID, or you can select a element also. Select all the elements having paragraph tag. Okay, select all the elements having paragraph and intro class. Okay, select all paragraph element with class intro. Select all the elements, all the divs with which are having paragraph p. Select all div elements and all paragraph elements. So if you put this comma, right? So these are CSS selectors. We will talk about these in the details. Like, you can do lot of things here. CSS selectors, while writing the CSS, we use all these symbols. So it will select only the paragraph, only those paragraph tag which are just immediate child to a div. Okay, select all paragraph element where the parent is a div element. Div plus p, these are just a CSS selector. Select all paragraph element that are placed immediately after div element. Similarly, other elements are also there. So these are selectors, all different kind of selectors you can pass. Even you can just specify the input type. Okay, like select all the elements where lang which is defined equal to pn. So this is property you can define on a particular node, right? Select all the elements where anchor tag is active, input type is checked, input type is default. Okay, we'll talk about this later. I mean, lot of things you can specify in the query selector all. Okay, these are called CSS selectors. And based on this CSS selector criteria, it will fetch all the DOM. So query selector all rules all the way of accessing the DOM nodes. Okay, that's it. You can just look at the documentation, what all these methods are doing. We talked about how to access the inner HTML, how to access an attribute, how to update a style of a DOM node, how to set a new attribute to a DOM node.